We found a boat, then sailed away from the island. We had to. We didn't belong there. The new guy's name was George. I noticed when the anarchist said his name, he said it with a thick Belkan accent.
How did you know that he was from Belka?
Well, both my parents were from Belka, so...
You never told me that. They say that Belkans are known for their conspiracies.
That's just a stereotype. Now, I simply stated my honest opinion and was thrown in jail for it.
The princess sat there looking miserable. That was a dumbass stunt she pulled back there, but it got us on this boat.
Take a look at that. This ship is heading for a single rope that's hanging down from the sky. Do you know how far the end of that rope reaches? Outer space. No. It is a direct connection to the very potential of mankind itself. Or at least it was until war erupted. It's my strong belief that the rope might be connected to a very distant, faraway source of great conflict and strife. Even long before the war, the whole world started falling apart once Harling began trying to build it. I often wonder what was going through Harling's mind when he was trying to destroy the very thing that so many people were sacrificed in order to create.
Sacrificed? What do you mean?
Have you seen all of those countless old space shuttles on Tyler Island that are no longer in use?
Yeah. I always thought of them as a good source of scrap. They're an obsolete technology that was abandoned during the construction of the space elevator. Which would mean that if the space elevator was destroyed, it would be that much harder for mankind to reach the stars. Until we find another way.
But even then, Harling still went ahead and tried to destroy it. At the cost of his own life.
That's not the way I heard it. What I heard was that he sacrificed himself to protect the tower from an incoming missile.
Oh, I was told he tried to fly his ship into the tower in order to destroy it.
I wonder which story is true, Your Royal Highness.
I don't know. Looking at it objectively, it's reasonable to believe that Harling had both options before him.
When it comes to which one you think he took, I guess it's like a mirror.
Yes, it is. It's like a mirror looking into your own soul, based on whichever choice you believe it was. At the moment, though, I can only see darkness. I think that thing should be destroyed.
It's time for the briefing. Although, since we don't have any contact with HQ, it's not like this is an official mission. Anyway, it looks like the seizure of Tyler Island and the relief from Osea have been postponed. In the meantime, we just have to do what we can to survive. Since losing its capital city of Ferbanti, Yerusian forces have separated into smaller, autonomous factions. It looks like Yerusia's largest force and leading faction will pass through the area around this base. The space elevator is significant to them, so they're probably heading there.
Should we intercept?
Why? I doubt they're gonna start a fight now.
Our top priority should be to get home. Let's go already.
Yeah. It's not like we have the supplies, power, or even a real reason to put up a fight. But what are we going to do if they bring the fight to us? We need to be ready to push them back. If we head inland from here towards Arusha, there's an old castle that's been converted into a stockpiling base, Shilaji Castle. It's currently occupied by some of the Arusian forces that broke off, but we need ammo and fuel. They appear to have converted a freeway into a runway, so we can expect them to have the capacity for air combat. But they'll be easier to handle than Arusha's lead faction. While we can't use all our aircraft to attack, the transport carrying the stolen supplies needs support. Okay, Strider Squadron. You head out first and neuter the dogs at the stockpiling base. Rendezvous with Cyclops Squadron, who will bring the transport. Then we bring the supplies back to this base.
Got it.
Aircraft are our only threat.
Sounds good.
We'll make it. We're all gonna fly home. Together.
Strider Squadron, aircraft prep complete. You're cleared to taxi.
No Ocean forces are in the region ahead. No allies here. No need to ID your target. We've set a number of priority targets, focusing on their anti-aircraft weaponry. Okay, team, to work.
Unidentified aircraft, not sure if friend or foe.
Strider 1, target destroyed.
Fire anyway. We don't have time to be wondering if they're friendlies or not.
So, we capture this base and take the fuel and supplies. That's the plan, right, Trigger?
You take if you want to live. That's how it was where I grew up.
I was just double-checking mission orders, Hushin.
Our anti-air guns are destroyed! Abandon and fall back to our rear position! Retreat!
There are more vehicles along the road. They don't appear to be military. Arusian refugees. They must be fleeing since the conflict got worse.
Unidentified aircraft! Identify at once or we'll lose fire!
What are you talking about? They already are firing on us! The enemy's confused.
I know! Help us here! No, we're the Ocean Army! We're all out of ammo! Don't give up! We're not going to lose our country again!
Target locked.
Strider 1, target acquired.
Strider 1, target eliminated.
There aren't that many. Aim carefully and take them down!
So what's this faction split from the Arusian military?
The autonomous state of Shilaji used to be a nation. The region has always leaned towards independence. Those who want to restore their homelands flock to it. Apparently, their core consists of officers from Vaslij, which neighbored Shilaji.
Are they our enemies?
They're our enemy's enemy, but not our friends.
Locked on, Bandit.
I'm trying to break!
The resistance is strong. They seem pretty desperate.
Dust by the lock! We don't have enough AA weapons.
Fox 2.
Nickel.
Strider 1, target acquired.
Nickel.
Bandit my sight.
Target destroyed.
Fox 2, they're bombing us! We're unable to use the sand!
coming up on the castle. Let's hurry up and capture this base so we can get its fuel and supplies. Shit!
I feel like we're a group of burglars.
Don't say that. This is for our survival.
Yeah, I know.
Nicol.
That's Shilaji Castle.
Nicol.
Thanks already.
Taking both civilians and refugees without discrimination. Get away from the stone buildings and take shelter somewhere sturdier or underground. Drop where you are and cover your head with your jet engines.
Your life. to reclaim that which you call home. Furthermore, we must find someone to guide you.
Nicole.
I am not that person. Yummy.
This Legion squad will be retreating.
Nicole.
Those fighting below are advised to temporarily withdraw. Don't die. As long as we're alive, our hopes and dreams live on.
Hey, look at the color of that plane. Damn, that's the flames of hell. Time for payback.
Negative. It's no good. I can't get close enough.
Leave it to Trigger. The rest of us will just get in the way. The rest will run on the perimeter to catch whatever slips through. Welcome. Might just cost us our lives.
Not bad.
Hit on unidentified aircraft. The enemy mobility is still unfazed. Keep up the attack.
Something to guide us. I can't help anyone other than you. Being together, now it taught me something. Drone fighters don't belong on the moon. They have been placed in the cosmos of the skies. And they're what the Pulse Legion Air Force should be fighting against.
Unidentified aircraft, land in plane and surrender. Why do you feel the need to continue fighting on your own?
That's funny. It seems like one of the pilots is also fighting alone.
He's not alone. Look around you.
I see. Perhaps it would have been best to entrust the future to pilots like that. Let me test him then, to see if he's truly worthy.
Strider 1 has been hit. Are you alright?
He's flying, but if he takes another hit, it's a miracle you're not in a million pieces.
The sky's been sliced wide open. The external unit model being destroyed.
That bastard's moving in a way that minimizes the damage even when he's hit. Keep firing those missiles until you blow to pieces. Down, Mr. X.
Yeah, it's gonna take something else entirely to end this thing. I just don't know what. Refugees. They must be fleeing since the conflict got worse.
Unidentified aircraft. Identify at once or we'll open fire.
What are you talking about? They already are firing on us. The enemy's confused.
I know.
The resupply went well. We should be okay on food and fuel reserves for a little while at least. Luckily, the rumor that the Arusian army is advancing nearby is only a rumor. There's no sign of them from the skies.
Rumors.
Rumors, rumors. This is what happens when you lose communications. But we got one good fact. The plane Trigger shot down was an advanced model of the XO2 Wyvern. It was developed in the last Continental War. Erugia had a lot up their sleeves. Apparently, they were even supposed to have Belkan aircraft back in the First War. What if Trigger couldn't shoot it down? Just thinking about it gives me chills. We're lucky to be here. In war, you never know what's lurking behind the curtains. But it looks like everything's loose now. A solid chain of command, rest periods after sorties, a battlefield where you know friend from foe. All of that's gone now, lost in a fog of confusion. Feels like a distant dream. Now, just how the hell are we gonna get out of this mess?
When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory'd been converted to a production line for Arusian drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there. Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from 2 wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised. My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose: to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Arusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then, for all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it, and now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Arusia? My grandfather had only one wish, to continue soaring through the endless skies. That was the only place where he felt alive. But I don't even have a country to call home, let alone the sky. The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer mine. Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother. We have to learn to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now. The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are two aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it, and the two planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others? We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Arusia after all.
Good. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now, it's the root of this chaos.
I wonder.
Yes?
I wonder which path you would choose when looking at Harling's mirror.
Let's get the briefing started.
We've done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, it'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general network. Here is what it contained. Apparently, the Arusian radicals have gathered around the space elevator, as it's a source of energy. Give the warmongers powerful energy source, and you give them the luxury to keep on fighting. In response to this, people from both Osea and Arusia have joined forces and will take down the final arsenal bird in a saturation attack from the air and the sea. Once that's achieved, they'll take the space elevator from the aggressors.
Has the source been verified?
It could be fake. I hear you. Take a look at what's written at the end. Hey, dumbass. If you want to bring the world back from the brink, go to the lighthouse and see the future.
Dumbass? Sounds familiar.
It certainly does. It's from those guys we met in Tyler Island. The 444 Squad. It's a message to all those looking to end the war. But I also think it's a message for Trigger.
Guess we'll do what it says.
Okay. Well, then I'm thinking we go roast that damn bird.
Looks like we're all on the same page. It's time to end this war. Time to fly, guys. Let's go get that arsenal.
Strider Squadron, sortie ASAP.
Hostiles. You two aces, I think it is time to show us what you've got.
We don't have two anymore. Guess nobody told them.
That's quite true, Count. It's not just two. Wiseman trained his squad well. Everyone still entered as an ace. He'd be proud of you all.
To all of you who have gathered here, regardless of your country, this is headquarters of the Ocean Army Southern Command. Wait, we forget that designation. We are a coalition formed exclusively for the sole purpose of taking down the Arsenal Bird. Wait until we're ready to strike the Arsenal Bird in unison.
Roger. Roger. He's speaking on an open channel. The enemy can hear everything he's saying. There's no other choice. The Illusion aircraft are in the coalition as well.
This is Skull Squadron and Rigel Squadron of the Illusion Air Force. We're here on our own. Lancaster, we're entering your airspace.
Up. Engagement is forbidden.
Don't worry, I know. We need every bird we can call upon. Even if they were flying with the guy that killed Wiseman. Some of their squadrons are in weird formations.
They have manned aircraft and UAVs in flight mode.
All this just to keep a war going.
How many more do we need to take out?
Shoot them down one at a time. They'll run out eventually.
On our side? Strike, I haven't seen Gunner in a long time. Again, three strikes?
once the leader went down.
I thought as much. Drones without leaders are slow as hell. The biggest flaw in their slave mode.
Strider 1,
one is this a rebellion? This is battle for independence.
Some coalition this has turned out to be, huh? Now keep talking big once the war's over, too. Get on it. We need something or someone to guide us.
Together. We're gonna win this, but not. I'm bailing out!
Cameras have been set in place. They monitor distortions in the space elevator. Those are the locations we want to target. If the sensors go bad, the elevator's observation system will think the elevator has fallen. Until its safety can be confirmed, all microwaves will be stopped.
Oh, I get it. What a party.
I was gonna do it myself. Dumbass.
Helios launched from the Arsenal Burn. Five seconds. Three, two, impact now.
Recording that. It's all over.
Helios arriving in 10 seconds. 5 seconds to arrival. Two. Inbound.
Damn it! I'm taking some damage. One aircraft hit. No, two.
Say goodbye.
Lancaster warning all aircraft. I have multiple blips on my scope.
Here they come.
That's something.
Hey, look at the Arsenal bird.
Lasers!
HQ, we have a problem. The damage to the Allied fleet is extensive.
That was some pretty impressive firepower. I, for one, did not see that coming.
The active protection system operated as expected. We should launch another saturation attack. Now, power. You also the Arsenal bird.
Trigger! Missile incoming!
It's readying its APS. All aircraft, break off from the Arsenal bird.
That was close. It's on the AWACS. I would have been a goner.
Locked on bandit.
Cosette, that's not the control room. Go through the airlock and get on the maintenance elevator. Head to the top of the windbreak.
Nice kill.
Do you think you can put on that pressurized suit by yourself? You'll never get it on with those frills. Yes.
I'm getting sick of that arrogant bastard. Seriously.
No good.
Nothing phases this thing. Where are we supposed to hit it?
All aircraft. We can no longer commence with a second saturation attack. All aircraft. Separately engage in direct attack.
HQ, it won't be easy to take down the Arsenal bird with conventional weaponry. All the ace pilots in the world won't save us unless we have a plan.
Give us time. We'll see what we can do.
You're just thinking about it now?
Target acquired.
Cover any bandits that's hit.
Nickel.
That bandit is still on your back.
UAV eliminated. It's readying its APS. Installed.
What?
Nicole.
If we destroy the docking modules, the supply unit will break off and crush the supply. That would be bad to at least move. Fire on fire, we can cut that burn. Theoretically, that would be more possible if you're an experienced pilot.
Nicole.
There will be a frozen bit.
Yeah, but our guy's more than just an experienced pilot. Trigger, let's do this.
Is he really that good of a pilot? I bet on it. Besides, if he thought it was impossible, he wouldn't have said anything.
Watch out! The drones are falling! The refugees. Everyone calm down. Do you want to get yourself killed? George! Cowboy! Get back here!
I can't leave that girl to die.
Fine, fine! Get her, but be quick about it!
Is everything okay? The drones are acting odd.
Run! Run! Careful!
Docking module destroyed. That's two of them.
Don't let yourself be distracted. Just focus on what you need to do.
Is everything okay?
Some people were crushed. But the kid Tabloid went after is safe. He ran that distance with a girl in his hands.
Good. What about Tabloid?
Nicole.
Is he safe?
Nicole.
George and the girl were saved.
Module destroyed. One left.
Think that it missed.
Nicely done.
This will be a good story to tell my son.
Just try to stay out of his way.
Strata 1, target acquired.
Take your six.
Caution. Pull up. Caution.
Is this really taking
me
to be a
human
pilot?
Watch it. Enemy has a lock on you.
Get your pal.
Altitude rapidly.
Arsenal.
Even in death, that thing is intimidating.
I can't just snap my fingers and make a plane. Believe me, I wish I could. Right now, we needed one. Bad. When we were coming over on the boat, I remember seeing an aircraft carrier. That gave me an idea. The Admiral Anderson. The name of an old sailor. When the first drone started attacking, this ship wasn't ready for battle yet. It was still in the dock, getting all rigged up. So they rushed to get her ready. I know about Anderson. In the previous Ocean War, he was the commander of a ship that sent out the last fleet of jets. They say the deck was sloping so bad as it sank, the last plane barely made it off. Those fighters ended the war. That story gives me a little bit of hope, especially at a time like this. We're all in the same boat, like it or not. If this war keeps going on like it is, it'll be the end of everything. The military loaded this thing to the rafters with planes. Some were fighters that were going to be delivered to bases in occupied territory. It was hit before it could complete the mission. Jackpot. The hangars were loaded with goodies. This scrap queen's got work to do.
Trigger, everyone, listen up. The operation was a success. Erujian defense forces have been neutralized, and all Arsenal birds are down. However, those two new drones buzzing around have royally screwed up our plans. The Ocean and Erujian Coalition's air forces are in a sorry state thanks to them. We might not even have any viable aircraft. According to the Scrap Queen, the drones are trying to use the space elevator's transmission capabilities to send their data to drone manufacturing plants across the continent. They're trying to strengthen their numbers. What's worse, their data contains a depth of war experience, so the newer aircraft will be more tactically advanced. If that's the case, this war will never end. We need to take both drones down, no matter what it takes. We'll do it, so we have homes to go back to. Well, the Scrap Queen's on our side. She says she can make any aircraft fly. This is our final mission. Trigger, let's go. We've got a goddamn war to end.
Strider Squadron, takeoff prep complete.
Hey, can you hear me? That craft is in peak condition. I even buffed up the canopy for a nice shine, so you can really see the sky. Take care, Trigger. When you get back, let me know what you saw.
Let me see that. Trigger, wish I could have flown with you.
Picked a plane and an injured pilot would only slow you down. I feel for him now.
He's the one who took off just now.
patience with us.
I'm seeing they're sticking around, too.
I don't care what country anyone's from. What counts is knowing who the real enemy is. Right, guys?
Affirmative. And I think everybody here knows the score. We all know who to follow. Commence mission. All aircraft, follow Trigger.
Roger that. Understood.
All right.
Understood.
Roger.
The space elevator is able to broadcast and communicate. With the information infrastructure down, it's the only place capable of wide area data transmission. The drones are waiting for it to power up again.
Clever little bastards.
Go leader to Longcaster. UAV is confirmed in direction of travel. ATC abandoned.
All aircraft, converge on Skull Squadron. Surround and shoot them down.
Strider, keep it coming. Let's do it, Ocean Man.
Welcome. UAV reacting. Damn, they're fast. All aircraft, stay sharp. Intercept now.
Now, who's the market for? Exactly. This is Gold 2. Get out of there. This is Gold 2. I'm ready.
Salamander 3, Skull 2, lost. Damn it, that was quick.
I've never seen anyone fight like that. Provide support.
Friendly lost. Another confirmed down.
Damn it. Trigger scored a hit. We can do it. Aim low and shoot him down.
Good. The enemy is still flying normally, though. Keep pushing. Damage has to be adding up. The UAVs are equipped with laser weaponry. Watch where their nose is pointing.
Just like the eyes. I'm wearing complete copies of the eye. They've seen some serious upgrades. See, we'll separate human and unit.
Enemy has a lot. Evade! Alright, everyone. Regroup quickly while Trigger draws the drones away.
Strider 1, locked on target.
Pursuing enemy.
Missile did not connect. All aircraft, watch your six. Stay sharp. They'll creep up on you.
That's right. That's no use to be done.
Our signal is lost.
Our top eight, showing us how it's done.
That was definitely the most intense thing I've ever been in. Can't wait to tell my son about it.
The space elevator is just powered up. Looks like we made it in just the nick of time. Fortunately, you've prevented data that may have included Trigger's flying style from leaking. I've got a special bottle of wine for occasions like this. What do you say we open it?
Can you hear me? There's still one drone left.
Who the hell is that? More importantly, I thought Trigger destroyed all the drones.
It's thrown away its wings, yet it's still flying. Can anyone hear me? That aircraft needs to be taken care of.
She's right. I see something on the radar. The UAV is alive and kicking.
The UAV went into the undersea tunnel. That tunnel leads to the space elevator.
Trigger, you're gonna have to fly into the tunnel after the UAV.
Where's the escape vector?
There's enough space for him to turn beneath the elevator.
That's a suicide mission!
Count, where are you going? Rely on Trigger too much. He's gonna need help.
You can't be serious, Count.
Yeah, well, you had no problem with Trigger doing the same thing.
Trigger's different.
We'll see.
You damn fool.
Don't worry. I learned something from my last squadron. Stick with Trigger, and you'll make it.
Count, give me your status.
Alive.
Excellent, so you're both okay.
Whoa. What makes you think that?
No time to explain. The radio will cut out soon. It'll take a short time for the drone to send over the data. You need to destroy it as fast as you can.
There it is. UAV spotted. We finally found it. He's gonna need help.
You can't be serious, Count.
Yeah, well, you had no problem with Trigger doing the same thing.
Trigger's different.
We'll see.
You damn fool.
Caution.
Don't worry. I learned something from my last squadron. Stick with Trigger, and you'll make it.
Count, give me your status.
Alive.
Excellent, so you're both okay.
Whoa. What makes you think that?
No time to explain. The radio will cut out soon. Take a short time for the drone to send over the data.
There it is! UAV spotted! We finally found it! Clarence, I'm static when the gate closed. Do you think the UAV is operating the gates? Well, there goes our only way out. I thought we were gonna pull this off after making it through that maze. Don't worry, I'll think of something. I'll find us a way out. No sign of the drone. Did it take another path? Doesn't matter. We know where it's going. We can catch it. Trigger. The windbreak is hollow, and there's no ceiling all the way up. Not sure if my bird can handle it, though.
Fly! I know you can make it! I'll attempt a belly landing. Get out of here! Everyone's waiting for you!
Trigger.
Stall warning. Stall warning.
Is turning. It'll send its payload. Shoot it down, Trigger. Is turning. It'll send its payload. Shoot it down, Trigger. Trigger. Trigger's down!
send its payload. Shoot it down, Trigger!
thought of a way out of here. The space elevator.
Fly! I know you can make it! I'll attempt a belly landing. Get out of here! Everyone's waiting for you! I wanted to wait until I had less fuel, but I have no choice. Attempting to land. I don't think my plane will make it.
Anyway, here goes. Come on, baby, stay with me just a bit more.
Should we send in an evac team?
We can't give up. We have to wait.
Turning. It'll send its payload. Shoot it down, Trigger! Attempting to land. I don't think my plane will make it.
Anyway, here goes. Come on, baby, stay with me just a bit more.
Beacon of light!
Trigger. Strider 1 has returned to radar.
I did it!
That's our Trigger!
He's a damn hero!
No doubt. You're better than me.
Where's Strider 2? Damn it. Does anyone have eyes on Count?
Wish y'all could have seen that.
You damn fool. What's your position?
Watching Trigger climb. I guess it's my fate to watch from down below.
Yeah, well, we're all in the same boat there.
Yeah, well, I guess we are.
We're sending help. Give us your coordinates.
Directly under the space elevator. Elevation is minus 500 meters.
Minus? Hey, Trigger. You dumbass. Tell me something. What color's the sky up there?
Belt. I can't tell you how proud I am to be the first to land at
Wait, what was that transmission?
This is Captain Kay Nagase of the spaceship Pilgrim 1. The ocean of stars in our galaxy is finally within our reach. To the pilot who generously gave this spaceship a place to dock, we are forever grateful. The universe lies ahead of us, waiting to be discovered. Now, at last, we have a gateway to ascend to it, over and over again.
It's all coming together for me. Today was the day, the moment of her return.
I salute the pilot who gave us all a future.
Skies unknown. The path to mankind's vast future remains standing, Granddad. The refugees built the settlement for themselves at the base of the space elevator. A humanitarian mission from Yuktuvania airdropped some supplies for them again today. Thanks to the princess, the whole world was pitching in to help these people. Handing out the relief supplies would have been a perfect gig for that anarchist dude. But since he's dead now, the job went to the guy from Belka, George. I guess Tabloid got that new system he wanted in the end. Mihai's granddaughters are helping out too. Mihai. That cranky old geezer's here with us, too.
I never wanted to create anything, and now here I am, clinging to life. Watching as my grandchildren and their generation make a new future for themselves and the world. Is this my punishment, then? All I do is lie here, wasting away. I'll never know the freedom of flying the open skies ever again. I've been grounded, and my wings have been clipped.
You know what having peace in the world means? It's being able to die in your own bed at a ripe old age. Peace is what those girls are working so hard for here. We got a bunch more refugees today. And the princess? She's looking to the stars. Dark blue, to the heavens and beyond.
Can you hear me?
Tu te souviens de nos fleurs préférées qui chantaient tout près de nous du jour de ta déclaration d'amour
Trigger, Count, we've received official confirmation.